I'm out here. We brought something different, something I wanted to test out. I saw a review this week that Iridium 242 did, and I thought I'd give this thing a shot, and I'd take it through some paces out here in the woods. We're going to have a little fire. So I've got this little China-made chainsaw. Okay? It even says chainsaw on it. Came with a couple batteries. We're going to see 24-volt batteries. I'll put a link to his review in the description so you can take a look at that, but we're going to try this thing out. Let's see how this works getting some wood. Well, that cut through that pretty quick.
That's good and sharp.
Yeah, I brought my gloves, but I didn't put them on. So now there's no safety on this thing at all. So take the battery off if you're doing anything. I want to check to see how the blade tension is. Let's see, it's loosened up a little bit. So I might do a little fine tuning on that.
That's not bad. That's about where you want it. You want it a little loose. Otherwise, it'll skip off the bar.
Okay. All right. Well, then the expert here, Billy, says that I should be good to keep going. So we'll keep using this on more wood, see how long this battery lasts. I brought two batteries. And then we'll try it. We're not burning anything in half because we have a little chainsaw. So we're going to try something bigger here. This is all dead. This tree is down. Let's pull some of these branches off. Uh-oh. What do you think about this one?
Not bad. That this should be able. That's probably the biggest you want. It was right there. Nice.
That's actually pretty impressive. I'm impressed with that. We'll see how long it lasts. That's the next thing. Is it worthwhile taking this like car camping, or even just an overnight where you're not taking a lot of gear where you can afford the extra weight of this? We'll see how well it does here. Keep cutting more wood up. Okay, so what I'm learning here, I'm really impressed with this thing. I actually cut through a piece that was larger than the blade here. I'll show it to you. This piece right here. And I had to go through one side and then turn around and go through the other side. But so far, this thing's working really good. It does tend to overheat a little bit. When it overheats, it shuts down on its own. And then it takes, boy, maybe 6 or 7 seconds before the motor will re-engage. But I'm still on this main battery. We've gotten plenty of wood so far for our initial fire. And then we're gonna collect more and cut more and keep going until the battery's dead. But so far, I'm extremely surprised with this. We've done a lot of wood and I'm still on the initial battery for this. So I'm pretty impressed. The blade length could be a little bit longer, I think, for what I'm doing. I mean, it is a pruning saw. I mean, it's not designed for big wood cutting like this. But so far, it's working really good. I haven't even touched the second battery, so I'm very, very impressed. All right, I want to give my final opinion of this little F.Easy.D garden chainsaw, pruning saw. Finally did put the second battery on. Plenty of juice left, though. We've got plenty of wood here for the rest of the day and into the evening if we needed to stay, and plenty of power still left in this thing to go ahead and get more wood. And there's plenty of dead wood around here that we could clean up. So I am very, very impressed with this. If I were to say that there's a couple things I don't like about this, number one is there is no safety on this. There's no way to lock out this button, so if you're going to transport it, you need to take the battery off, and take the battery off if you're doing any work on this at all. It's very easy to hit the button and have this thing kick off, and you could probably lose a finger The other thing that I do not like about this is there is no cover included with this, and I really wish there was a little plastic cover over it, because then I could put it inside my pack or strap it to my pack and feel a little bit more comfortable. I actually hand carried this out just because I was concerned about doing any damage to my pack. I did have a little issue with the chain loosening the more I used it. No different than any other chainsaw from what I gather. So have your little tools to make adjustments, and then there is no oil included with this, so I just have a little 3-in-1 oil I put on there. But extremely impressed with this. I'm very glad I saw the review from Iridium 242, and I will, like I said, I'll put a link in the description below to his review video. But I put this through the paces. I'm really impressed with it so far. Whether or not I'm going to keep it, well, I honestly, because of the fact that it doesn't have a safety and it doesn't have a cover, I will probably not be keeping this. But I definitely think that this size worked really well. I wish it was maybe an inch or two longer. This is a 4-inch chain. A 5 or 6 would be great, but using something like this in the woods is something that I'm actually really impressed with. It saved a lot of time. Didn't have to worry about hand sawing a ton of wood, and it made really short order out of it, going through all the wood out here. So I like it. I'll give this a thumbs up. I'm glad I saw the review. Thanks again to Iridium 242. And if you watch his video, he has a link to his Amazon store, which will then link you over to where you can actually buy this, and that helps him out as well, which is exactly what I did. So thumbs up for this. Very impressed with it. We'll see how it holds up if I continue to keep it, or maybe you'll see me out with something a little bit beefier and with some of the safety features that I wanted on it. But thanks for watching this video. It was great. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe.